Technicolor's first processes used just two colours. This meant only a limited part of the colour spectrum could be reproduced. Red and green were chosen as the component colours because Technicolor wanted to prioritise accurate skin tones and foliage. Certain colours, such as blues, purples, and yellows, could not be reproduced properly. But if the colours in front of the camera were carefully controlled, stunning results could still be obtained. The company's first process was unveiled in 1917 with the feature-length demonstration film, The Gulf Between. The process required a special camera and proprietary projector, which ran black and white film screened through colour filters. The additive projection used two adjustable lenses to line up the colour records on the screen. This process worked in the laboratory, but proved too complex for commercial use. When shown to the public in 1917, the projection repeatedly failed, producing prominent colour distortions on screen. After this disappointment, Technicolor retreated from the public eye to work on an entirely new camera and new printing process. The improved camera was invented by Joseph Arthur Ball and utilised a refined prism design with red and green filters. Between 1921 and 1930, more than 40 of these cameras were made. The first 12 of these cameras were manufactured by the Waltham Machine Company in Massachusetts, while the later ones were made by the Mitchell Camera Corporation in California. From the outside, it looked like an ordinary black and white camera, but it was about a third larger. Extra space was required inside for the beam-splitting prism behind the lens, which separated the incoming light down two paths. A red record and a green record were recorded simultaneously onto black and white film. The film was then advanced two frames, and the same process was repeated. This meant twice as much film was exposed as normal, and the camera had to run twice as fast. These two records were vertically inverted or flipped on the film, foot to foot. When the prints were made, the two colour records on the camera negative were printed onto two separate strips of film. The silver in the image was then removed, and the two strips were glued together back to back or cemented. The glue was actually more like a solvent, which when carefully applied, melded the films together very strongly. Each side of this double-coated film was then dyed the corresponding colour. The green record was dyed red, then the film was turned over, and the red record was dyed green. This created a subtractive colour print because it removed parts of the spectrum from the projector's light, instead of adding the colour records together as Technicolor's first process had done. And unlike the first additive system, the resulting film prints could now be shown in any standard film projector anywhere in the world. The first film shot and released in this process was the self-produced feature The Toll of the Sea from 1922, starring Chinese-American actress Anna May Wong. Although the results achieved with cemented printing generally looked great and were frequently praised, there were a number of inherent technical problems. Because these prints had emulsion on both sides and were thicker, they were more vulnerable to scratching, which appeared either red or green on screen. And these prints also had a tendency to warp and buckle, making them harder to keep in focus. As a result, many prints had to be recalled to Technicolor's Boston lab for reconditioning, which cost Technicolor a lot of money. This problem was most apparent during the release of Douglas Fairbanks's The Black Pirate in 1926, and it damaged Technicolor's reputation. It wasn't until the dye transfer printing process was introduced that these technical issues were finally overcome. From an archival perspective today, these cemented prints can be quite problematic. The green dye has a tendency to fade over time, leaving just an orange or red image. Photochemical duplication and digital technologies can correct for some of this dye loss, but sadly, the original colours of a faded cemented print cannot be fully recovered.